How rude, people calling me. The nerve. Little yellow oncidium, which it is not. it has a bit odontoglossum-like flowers. And there is a hint of pink in the lip. And they smell like biscuits. Yeah, it's not very an appealing smell. At least not to me. Same as with twinkles. But one spike and nine flowers open, I think that's a good one. Where did you hide? Well, there you go. Ta-da. Okay, the larger ones. Well, larger. This is Odontoglossum Geyser Gold, and this is the one that Roger has in bud at the moment and doesn't know what it is. I made a comment on that video and I said I had the pale one with one spot, but I have the pale one with multiple spots on the lip. So this is a Geyser Gold, and not sure if that's an official name, but it comes from a very big nursery in Holland. It has a sweet floral scent. Yes, they all do. This one should be starting making new stuff, but there's one. Now there will probably come another one, but I'll have to check that one. You need a new spot. Yeah, I'm screwing up the arrangement on the table by doing this. Miltonidium Pieterkamp. And that was a resounding decision from all of you. It's still in flower, but not for long. It's also still in the pot where it should get out. I haven't checked for new stuff yet, but this bulb is, this one needs to repot. This bulb can go. This one smells like warm cinnamon. Yeah. It's actually a pretty tasty smell. You can see here that this spike is behind this one. This one is taking up more energy, so it can produce larger flowers. That makes me wonder, because they are both on a different bulb. Oh yeah, this is, I really hope this is one bulb. This is, oh man, this sucks. Now this one is firm. This one is, this one is also, but this is no bueno. Yeah, emergency repot, not now. Yeah, you can't win them all. The green zygote is probably beyond saving. And that's not my fault, that's not the shop's fault where I got them, it's just a bad plant. A while back I had a very big shari baby, and that one rotted before my eyes, really, 2 days. So, it happens. Okay, the last one in pot. This is the Bellara Marfitch Renaissance Coral. The dumbest name ever. It had a second spike when I got it. Two, in fact. I cut one off because the flowers were frumpy. And these turned out really, really nice. Really, really nice. Don't know where we are. Oh, there we go. It has a a flashy color, a little bit of waxy flowers, and this discoloration is suspect. Don't have it on this one, but yeah, you can see that there's Miltoniopsis miltonia in it. I haven't checked for new growth yet, so, but judging by these leaves here, there's, oh, there we go. New growth. Yes, yes, new growth. What are you doing here? Nope. Does it smell? Hold up. It smells like oranges. Fresh peeled oranges. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That is very strange. Okay. As I said, this is the last of the potted ones. So now I'm going to take on the Herculean task of showing you all my mounted Oncidiums. Yes. Behold. Okay, the mounted ones. And now we're going to get into the big stuff. I have small stuff, but mostly big stuff. Miltonia Sunset. Yes. It's damn pretty, but I like the flowers better when they are a little bit older, when the really, really strong yellow fades. The lip is really, the inside is really pretty. This one is freshly mounted. Oh, so I'm going to have to wait for a while to see how it reacts. But they can be mounted. I believe that Roger has one mounted and that does really, really yippy. Big one. This is a division of my Brassia Scylla Tolkien. Yes. I shouldn't have done that, really, but it ate away his board completely. There was nothing left. It was held together by the roots and the rest was soil. Really, it was completely eaten. Yeah, it's still taking its time to recover, but I have one massive new growth and a very happy root system. Does you have another growth? Well, not apparent. But this will not flower for me in 2 years, I think. Yeah, it needs to recover. This is the other piece of the Sandrara. And it fell into three pieces. Or I pulled it into three pieces. No, it was an accident. Yes, it was an accident and the rest is my fault. It has still some flowers. Really pretty. Sweet smelling. Not in focus. No, they are. No, they're not. Ah, screw it. It has two really big healthy bulbs, which will start rooting very, very soon. Yeah, this one is going to make it. Again, this is the variegated one. Never seen a variegated Brassia. Yeah, I treat this as a Brassia, regardless of the name. Yeah, this is still a bit ambiguous. This is a Brassia with very, very dark purple flowers. In focus, thank you. It has a peppery smell, and I think that's a bit of a trait for these. Yeah, this is, there's an eye here, there, and an eye there, but well, one bulb, it's not much. The flowers will be cut today because I know what they look like, don't know what it is, but that's okay. It's a Brassia. Again, another Brassia, and this one, I think it's a Longissima. And that's referring to the length of the bulbs. But I could be wrong. I have no idea what this one looks like when it's flowered. It has one new growth. It's a bit floppy on the board. Well, that can be corrected. You see those brown spots? That's rather typical for Brassias, at least on the young shoots. And here you can see what happens when there are two growth on the same bulb. This one is stunted, it's behind. And when this one is fully grown and it starts recycling food, because at this moment it takes from this one and the big one, as soon as it starts giving back, then this one has a chance. But that will never grow as big as you want it and probably never have flowers. But yay. I think this one has yellow spidery flowers. I'm not sure. I could look that up, but I won't do it. Yeah, this looks a little odd. This is the Meltonia spectabilis. Yes, the white with purple flowers. And it just got mounted on a piece of branch. Yes, this is completely wood. And well, it's not been, yeah, just a few days. So we'll have to wait and see how this one reacts. You can see here down at the bottom, there are roots growing. So that one has to be peeled back there as well, because there is a new growth coming. Meltonia spectabilis hybrid. This is Odontoglossum Jungle Monarch. When I got it, it was just this one and this one. Not very much, but one pretty new growth. Oh, and an extending root system. Wow, I touched all the flowers and now there's a mix of bubblegum in the air. Well, I can't chew, so I have to kick ass. Yes, that was a movie reference, and if you get that, you win a wet t-shirt. Well, this one is too small to do anything for the coming years, so let it grow. Let it blossom, let it flow. Okay, I had a tag, Eonopsis Popcorn Haruri. And it gets sprayed every day because a spray a day keeps the doctor away. It is a climber, and I hope I accommodated that wish. It has a few new growth. It's on green moss with a little bit of sphagnum at the side. I only mounted this 2 days ago. No, now I'm lying. Yesterday. But yes, this is the way to do it. I need to split this up in several parts because I've just only gotten one rack on to the next one.